Atlanta. We was talking to women and shit, and a female was basically saying all the shit she ain't gonna do.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? And me and my boy, we was talking to the females and shit. We was like, yeah, females be saying all that shit, but let a certain nigga with a certain amount of money, you know, invite you to a private island or something, you would go. You feel me?
Even when you got a man.
Even if you got a guy. You understand me?
You gonna get on that jet.
You gonna get on the jet. If he land, he say, man, we finna go to Cancun or whatever island, whatever.
Yeah.
Feel me?
No, we going to the Maldives. We going to, Belize, the private islands of Belize. You know
I mean? I guess if a female can't afford to take herself to those type of places, then that's when that matters. But if you can, it don't fucking matter.
That's
not true. What y'all talking about? I'm not going. I
about that time, Trish.
That's not true.
My arm shirt. Mm-hmm. I'm good.
That's not true.
Why you say it's not true?
Because it's a lot of females that got money but would rather spend another nigga's.
Oh, yeah. That's facts.
Some.
And won't take the time out to say, I'm going to plan this and spend this large amount of money. Unless, I have a real specific reason to do so, and somebody else has to come with me. Okay. And somebody else is coming, then they got to pay as well.
Well, as an entrepreneur, here's how you think, right? Mm-hmm. I'm taking time off of work, which means that there is going to be a slow up in either my concept or production. Then on top of that, you're just taking me. I don't know if you suck or if you're a good person or if you cool as hell. Your spirit is right.
Do all that matter?
Yes,
when
it
he,
do,
when he
you on a private island by yourself with this weird ass nigga.
No, he just said you'll be able to bring somebody, your friends.
Yeah, he just says somebody that is like a reputable person, that got a bag or whatever it may be, and that person invites you to an island and for you to bring your friends and stuff like that. Let's cut the friends out. You can bring one person, know what I mean? And it's going to be another 14 people there.
Yeah,
he's
going to have some other females too, for
sure. Or just other people in general. Uh-huh. You getting on the private jet, eyes y'all too. It's 2-2-2-2. He 2-2-2 everybody up. And it's just y'all. Hold on. Belize, private island, jet ski, 7 days, stuff like that.
Instagram trip. The idea Instagram trip.
Hold on. This is how I'm living. What I deserve.
I've had a relationship where that was my life, just being with this one person. So I know what that's like, and it's great. But I also think about my money, and I don't give a fuck about being in an island for 30 days. I need to accomplish my goals.
So you gonna turn it down
for a purpose? If it's not in alignment with my schedule, no, I'm not.
Have you ever, at some point, just within your whole little time frame, been a nigga breaker? I break niggas out here. Niggas pay me. They give me money.
Let's ask you this before you say that.
In my 20s.
Hold on, for the people that's at home right now that's confused, what we talking about? You understand me? It's the Cali Kickback. It's your boy Lewis Bell. You understand me? I'm in here with a few of my friends. You feel me? Some lady friends, a few of my player potters. You understand me? We chopping game. You understand me? And we asked my female friend, Ayona. You understand me?
What's up, y'all?
We asked her that if a dude.
Hold on. Before we get into that. Let Ayona let the people know who she is.
Oh, okay. Keep it P.
Thank you for that.
He trying to get. No. I'm just playing. We gotta add some humor to this shit. We've been hella serious on the Cali Kickback lately, man.
Just so the people know.
Yeah.
What's up, y'all? My name is Ayona. I'm from Chicago. I'm based in LA. I'm an actress, singer, writer, dancer, producer, director, all of the above. It's a pleasure to be here with y'all today.
I'm glad you coming on here, Chopping Game. You didn't even say all the other fancy stuff. Wasn't you on Insecure?
Yes, I'm on Insecure Season 5, Episode 502, 504, and 506. And Rap Shit.
Nice.
If y'all haven't seen Rap Shit.
There you go.
Shout out to that. What role did you play?
Played Risha. She worked in a barbershop with the guys, and she braided hair. She was also best friends with Kendrick, if y'all know who that is. Rap Shit, I played across from Chameleon. We got into a fight in the episode. So with some ratchet shit. It was fun though.
Yeah.
Was that your first big gig in acting?
As far as a credit for TV,
like a big credit.
I would say it's one of the major films. I have a film with Tori Hart too, but that one's more like of an indie.
Nice. I don't know who Tori Hart is, but
she's Kevin Hart's.
Yeah, I know who Tori is.
Okay, mm-hmm. Great. I wanted to ask you. This is what I was going to ask you. You say you're from Chicago, right?
Yes.
Do you see? Did you like find your passion in getting into acting while you was in Chicago, or was it always like something I'm going to move to LA to get into acting?
I actually moved here to sing. I moved here to sing and do music and dance. But there was just so much investment going into the studio and being a new person out in LA. I didn't really have like the financial backing or finances. I moved out here alone. So then I just started acting.
Oh, you didn't move out here with no nigga? That's how most of, not most, but a lot of people get to LA.
I don't have my own.
I'm just trying to be devil advocate. You understand
me? That's not devil's advocate. That's being appointive. Like, okay, women move to LA only when they got a guy.
I never said that.
That's almost what you said.
I said most of the time.
What? That's what I'm saying. Most of the time.
Nah,
if she made it a point that she said she came out here by herself.
She dolo.
So that's, is that different or is normal?
No, it's normal. I mean, I know a lot of people.
Is it different or is it normal?
I don't.
A lot of my homegirls came out here by ourselves. Nobody came with a family member or anything. But we all from Chicago, so we.
It's
just
a lot of Chicago niggas out
that's
here.
That's what I'm
man.
Saying. We came by ourselves.
I know a lot of niggas from Chicago that's out here. Them niggas be.
Another question, real quick. Do you find it complicated, right? You know, getting into film. From my experience, right, being from the streets, you know, wanting to act, right, but not wanting to get into film. In the let's say in the way that the industry says you have to like stat quo, like you know the stat quo way of getting into like into acting and stuff like that. Do you feel it's complicated to get into film without going through the traditional way?
No, I definitely don't. I think that we are more blessed in this particular time frame because it's really kind of up for independent creators and independent filmmakers. The platforms are there, the need for content is there, so I think at this stage we're super blessed. When I moved here, I went the traditional route. I started doing background, I had headshots, I was going to commercial agent castings and doing the step by step of it, got my SAG vouchers and all that. But you don't necessarily have to do it that way. Like sometimes if you just have the gifts and you can write, produce whatever, your first time acting in something can be your own project.
What's the other way?
She get it. I met you through skits. We was doing skits. I don't know if we did one, but I know we crossed paths from like sketches and shit. So what was the transition like? Is it difficult for a lot of people that's on social media? Because a lot of people don't really go the traditional route. Like a lot, like you said, we got social media. We can create our own content. But what's the difference from making skits and acting? What made you transition?
I was at the halfway point already with getting started through acting, so I'd already had like a couple credits under my belt in acting classes. When I met Jahan and I met Cornell, those were the first two people.
Oh, okay, that's how. Okay.
Do you know Jahan Jones or Cornell? You know any of those people?
Not on the top of my head, no.
Well, those were the major people at the time. This was like 2016. A whole bunch of them had just moved to LA. So it was kind of like the rising time period for
that.
Yeah.
From where?
I did from Chicago.
No, when you said that.
They moved from all over. Jahan's from the DMV.
Yeah, shout out my boy Jahan, man. Jahan Jones, he a good brother.
Yeah. Cornell's from Ohio.
Okay. Like, nice.
But everybody just came out here running time, so we started creating. And at that time, Worldstar was posting it, Baller Alert was posting it. Views was hitting in the upwards of 2-3 million per video because the algorithm hadn't gotten messed up yet. And so now things have shifted for sure because the algorithm ain't the same. They want you to pay for play. This is a little different, but I was already halfway through.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So real quick, so you said something earlier about film paying the bills. From my experience, film don't pay the bills. And I've been in quite a few film, you know, as an actor and so forth, but it's nowhere near paying the bills. What's your expectations of, you know, film paying the bills?
Well, I mean, I already kind of explained my journey starting through background, you know, at that time, my life wasn't extremely expensive when I moved here in 2012. I had a studio apartment. And so as my credits grew, as the acting experience grew, I was able to demand more on set. You know what I mean? So now I have a minimum with my agents and with my managers that I make sure I'm called in for. Mm-hmm. And through the relationships that you build over time, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? I can go to set tomorrow and make a couple thousand. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Just doing
tell that nigga, acting do pay the bills.
It pays. I'm blessed. So it pays my bills, but I know that that's not everybody's particular story.
I mean, I just understand, like, you know, SAG minimums, right. And you know, when they do pick up, you know, even for background or whatever it may be, you know, what is paid on a daily and, you know, and so forth. Now, granted, being picked up, you know, and getting paid that upfront money for the days, you know, that of shooting, but then. Once that money is paid, you kind of like relying on like the royalties and so forth. Right. You know what I mean? Every, you know, let's say
exactly.
6 months or so.
Yeah,
forth,
I mean, those are great. Coming in. Them royalties are fucking great. But yeah. Social media pay my bills too.
So. Okay, yeah, so that's what I was going to get to. Like, yeah. You know, when you talk about like paying bills, is it the acting?
It's all
what,
of it.
What the, you know, what traditional? Or is it more so like what you're doing with, you know, different, you know, social media and YouTube and stuff like that?
It's a whole
like
variety. I feel like that's why you got to have a bunch of hustles as an entrepreneur. You should have probably five or six different things going on. It don't make sense to just have one.
Exactly. Yeah. Nice. Let's get into the ratchet shit. You understand me?
You want to have fun. Come on.
Yeah, I know we all actors in here, but this the Cali Kickback, you understand me? And I didn't want to bring my lady friend on here to talk about some Hollywood shit. This Thug Mansion, you understand me? Let's get into the ratchet shit. Let's get back to what I was finna say.
Yeah.
with the jet. When you feel me? If you in a relationship? Are you single? Or are you in a relationship?
I'm in a relationship. I'm texting him now.
Oh, really?
Yes.
He know where you at, huh?
All times.
That's good. How long y'all been together?
3 years.
Oh, 3 years.
Y'all share each other.
That's a pandemic boost.
No, I don't do that. That's weird.
Oh, okay.
How is it being in a relationship with being in the industry?
I love it because it creates boundaries. I feel like it's a lot of creepy, weirdo shit in this industry. And I like to be protected in whatever way that is. I used to have my mom be my manager when I first started. Mm-hmm. So now my mom transitioned 2 years ago. But so now I feel like having a person that I can trust, like a partner, that shit is lit.
Mm. So your boyfriend is like your manager?
No, fuck no, not like
that's
that.
That's what I was
getting
out of it.
I meant like protection, like, okay, this is about, I'm in something, I'm in a situation. So no, I'm not going to cross that line with you. If you're trying to do business, let's do business.
Y'all met in the pandemic?
Yes.
Damn, you was in LA?
It was right before. I met him February of 2020. Yeah, right before the world.
You was outside before that?
I was trying to be. I was outside for like 3 months, and then no, it was like
get your ass.
You'd rather be in a relationship than being single, like, you know.
I'm dating. A serial monogamous, so it went 6.5 years with one person. After that, it was 4 years with somebody. Then
so are you one of those people that's like?
I try to get single. I'm trying to be like, oh, okay, I'm a date. Mm-hmm. That nigga like, nope.
So do you feel like you don't feel comfortable when you're not in a relationship?
No, I actually feel great when I'm not in a relationship, but they want it to be more than just something casual, which I respect and I appreciate. I like a person that know what they want.
Is it fair to say that you really don't know what it is really feels like to not be in a relationship because you're kind of like a serial, you know, monogamist?
I will say I don't know what it's like to be single now in this time, but I had years of being single throughout college and all of that.
Have you had a whole phase?
That was, I guess that considered, that was it.
You was fucking around college.
Yeah.
It's cool. That's good. So, yeah.
Is there any content out there?
What do you consider a whole phase?
Why would there be?
I mean, college. You know what I mean? That's what niggas think
do
of college.
Do you save your college content?
No, you know, when I did go to college, I was 30 when I went to college, right? I was trying to have
he
that
was
college.
30.
Yeah. Fresh out of prison.
30.
Oh.
Yeah, fresh out of prison. And I always looked at college and I want to live out that
you
shit.
You can't tell
that,
by his voice
you know,
he's been to prison?
Did you try? No, I couldn't tell
you. You know, niggas got prison voice that's real raspy.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm from the streets. Yeah, for sure.
But I know he been to jail. What the fuck?
Well, I had life in prison, you know what I mean,
oh,
for murder.
Oh, you blessed.
Yeah, I know, but some shit I didn't do, obviously. Yeah. But I came home and I went to college, and I wanted to live out that shit that they always talked about in college, like, you know.
You did it?
So you was R. Kelly at a college?
No, there ain't no R. Kelly at a college. Come on now, you take it. Come on.
I'm just trying to have fun. We can't bring no R. Kelly at college in that motherfucker.
Hey, Sacramento, man, get your tickets right now, you understand me? April 16th. Two shows, 7 p.m., 9 p.m. Get your tickets right now. The link is in the description. Yes, Lord.
Nigga. But, yeah, you know, you want to go to all the parties, you know what I mean? You want to have, like, those type of, you know, threesomes, foursomes, you know, and,
have you
know,
ever like had a threesome?
Parties and shit like that.
No.
No?
Mm-mm.
So you don't have that experience in college.
Would you have a threesome with your man?
I don't know.
You would.
I don't know.
You thinking about it?
I have no idea whether I would or wouldn't.
Really?
At this point in my life, no. But if I would or wouldn't, I have no idea.
Let me ask you this, because I feel like this is like we're attacking you a bit, right? What's some
things? I don't
things?
Feel attacked.
Okay,
cool. Yeah, she from Chicago.
I feel like we're asking you a lot of questions at once.
I'm ready for all of them.
Okay. I asked her, I said, do you want another woman to come on here so we feel attention? I'm ready for you niggas. I said, all right, come on, we mobbing.
Okay, no, for sure. What's some things as a... I know it's tough as like a woman in the entertainment industry, right? What's some things you wonder that you think your significant other wonders about what you got going on in your space?
I mean, this industry, especially being in comedy, is really heavy male. Like,
male
I'm
dominant.
Constantly around men and male energy. So I know that for every relationship that I've ever been in, that has been like a sticky situation because, I don't know, I just feel like it's difficult for a man to be okay with you going and filming with a whole bunch of guys all the time. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So you definitely have to be secure in whatever y'all built foundationally. But for the most part, I feel like that's the biggest issue. Just always being around. But shit, in the comedy world, the film world, is male dominated. It is what it is.
Yeah, because it's very hard being in a committed relationship, being in the entertainment business, for sure.
For you?
In general.
For you?
I just think for people. For sure, for me.
I'm asking him, too.
For me?
Yeah.
No, not for me.
So you in a committed relationship?
That wasn't the question, but not for me.
It's not difficult for you?
No.
What about you?
Well, until I get into a relationship like that, yes, it is.
Hmm. Why?
Well, I mean, because I'm just not, you know, it's a lot of bad bitches out here for one, right? You know, and when I say bad bitches, I don't say it in no super negative way, but they come on as bad bitches, like I'm a bad bitch out here, like, okay, damn, ooh, I like that, you know what I mean? And I just like that, you know, around, but, you know, I just feel like at some point when I do get, you know, that one bad bitch that just want to be like, hey, what's up, know what I mean, then... I don't think it's gonna be complicated.
So,
are you basing
like you being in a relationship based off how bad a girl is?
No, it's about, you know, the commitment between me and this, you know, this bad, you know, thing.
But you keep saying bad.
Yeah, I mean, because we just categorize her as like, you know, the bad bitch or whatever it may be. But now this woman, regardless if she's bad or not, I mean, I ain't fucking with none that ain't bad if I'm getting into a committed relationship. Now some shit I done probably like on a late night, maybe she ain't the baddest, you know what I mean? Maybe she had a fat ass or some shit like that, you know? But it's like the temptations, a lot of why men in the industry ain't in committed relationship is because of the temptation. I think
that's a cop out, and I say that for a lot of different reasons. But I just feel like you either know what you want or you don't. You don't want to play the field, like, cool, like, settle down and stop wasting that one person's time. But then if you want to play the field, then just be single and be honest about all your shit. I'm telling you, half of these women, they fuck with you because you keeping it 1,000. Now, when you start getting weird and lying about weird shit, then it's like, bruh, like.
Yeah. I
truly agree with you.
I agree with you as well. And you know what that is? in the industry, especially in urban culture, right? Mm-hmm. We live in a polygamous culture in general. So dating to me is dating. That's exactly what it is. I'm not in no committed relationship. I'm dating. So if I'm talking to one girl, I could be talking to this girl and talking to this girl too. As long as they know that I am dating and I'm not looking for no committed relationship. And women are out there doing the same exact thing, right? Until you get to that point where you have that conversation that say, yes, this is what I'm going to do. Mm-hmm. Now, there are a lot of people who sell relationships, now, man, you my boo, you my girl, and, you know, shit like that, to either get the coochie or get their way. Or even girls do the same thing for men, to get money or to get that bag and so forth and so on. But that's why I say we live in this polygamous type of culture, is because everybody is kind of just open, right? And it's just freestyling. So even if I said, hey, I really like this girl, you know what I mean? And then I tell her, like, look, I'm in, you know, let's have something, you know, that's monogamous, you know, just us. I don't know what the hell she doing with Tom, Dick, and Harry. And now I'm not going to put my emotion on the line, right, and my feelings on the line to get caught up because, you know, with her wanting to fuck with somebody else or something like that. Because a man's emotions is different than a girl. A girl could catch a man cheating all the time, right, and damn near get over it. If a man catch...
Is that true? Hold on.
No, hold on. Listen, let me finish.
He said a mouthful, but I'm going to respond to each thing individually. Yeah, go please. Ahead.
Let's take it to his pace. This is a running sentence.
It is. It is. Now, so for a man, right, if a man is being committed to a girl and that girl cheats on rant. And that girl cheats on him, look at the statistics of the amount of relationships and situations like that where it gets violent.
Okay, so to the first point that you said, I do understand why you're saying what you're saying. I think polygamous is a very interesting choice of word. But what I did hear in that is a respect and communication where all parties involved are aware of what's going on. So in that space, it's honorable. Now, the second thing that you're saying about, oh, I just feel like if a woman cheats compared to a man, that it hurts less for you guys than it does. I think that that's
No, I didn't say that. Okay. I didn't say it hurts less for men.
No, you said it hurts less for women than it does.
Well, the reaction of what a woman will, you know, react like is different than how a man react like. If a woman is in a committed relationship with this man and this man cheats, her reaction will be totally different than his reaction. If
what would be the woman reaction?
I feel like that's a case by case situation because I have friends that have complete non-negotiables. Like that's their non-negotiable. Like, nigga, no, you will not cheat on me. Yeah, that's their boundary.
And she's gonna walk away.
Yes, but some women.
It's
some
niggas that will shoot your ass for cheating on them.
Yeah, look,
don't sleep on them.
Listen, I get that. I understand that. Yeah, but if you look at the statistics,
you the type to get shot.
Nah, if you look at the statistics, right? No, he gonna shoot her. He getting violent. If a man is in a committed relationship with him, put yourself in that situation. And I'm not saying tell me what you'll do, but I'm saying
I don't argue with women.
If a man is in a committed relationship, I know about, you know, man emotions, right? I deal with man emotions. I've been through a relationship where, you know, I stopped talking to a girl. Not that I was cheated on, but we just broke up. And I still think of this girl, you know what I mean, four years later.
We using the term cheat very, you know, fluent in this conversation. What do you consider cheating from a, you know, like as good a female? Question. Like, what do you consider cheating?
Well, I feel like any form of disrespect to our alignment is a problem. Because if we are aligned in a way that says, like, okay, this is how I plan to respect you, this is how I plan to hold you up when I'm out in public, or behind your back, period. Mm-hmm. Like, I respect you in this way, and that's just what our thing is. Mm-hmm. If you cross that line, and now you doing some shit that I don't know about, or that you know I wouldn't approve of, because you've been with me, you learned me.
What do you consider cheating?
That's cheating.
What do you consider cheating, though? Like, if you're in a relationship, and you dating a man, your boundaries, of course, like most women probably will be, like, don't have sex with other women.
Something as big as, okay, you've had sex with somebody outside of this space that I'm unaware about, this is going on. Or something as small as you having conversation and entertaining or flirting with some person outside of this space that I don't know about.
I think flirting is argumentable.
Flirting, like,
hey, I want to take you to dinner. I want to spend some time with you, some intimate type space that we only should be. I can't be getting that intimate. You know what I'm saying? Like getting high with a female and y'all talking about like that's.
You consider that cheating?
I just think that's a lot because you opening yourself up for the susceptibility of anything to take place in that kind of energy. Like when you're changing that kind of energy.
Uh huh.
Okay.
Hmm. So for a male perspective, right? Like I feel like. A lot of people only base cheating as, like, you know, sexual interactions. But I agree with you, right? About, like, yeah, if you're doing all that, getting smoked out and going, like, do you think, like, if you receive some money from a guy, like, if a guy, you in a relationship, and a guy send you some money and you receive it and you use it, do you consider that cheating, like you cheat on your boyfriend?
If it's not an angel investor from my business or LLC or a job that I worked, yes, I do feel like that's a lot. Like, why am I accepting money from another man? That's something that I feel like my partner should be doing for me.
You better than a lot of these
others. Yeah, that's the right answer. But yeah, you
that's
wonderful.
That's the right answer.
I think it's very rare that a man is going to send you a money for nothing. Like, I rarely see that.
Well, kind of trying to court you for the coochie.
I mean, they will do it. Yeah. They will send you, but there are expectations for sure on the other
side.
What
about if you ask your man for something, right? That he can't provide it. Say, for instance, if you needed $1,000, right, for your business, and your man couldn't afford that to loan you $1,000 or give you $1,000. And the next man, you just have a conversation, you out, you having drinks, and you conversating about what you trying to do, what you trying to achieve, and then you tell a guy, man, I'm short on $1,000, you know what?
It just depends.
If he give you that, would you accept that?
If this is a particular project, like, we're going to do it the right way. Like, you're going to put it in a cashier's check, LLC, you're going to be a producer on the project, like, whatever the situation
is. So if he just like, here, take the $1,000, you ain't going to take it just like
that. It has to be on a level.
I mean,
just out of respect for myself and out of respect to know, like, okay, yes, you gave me this $1,000, but I know that nobody do nothing for free. I don't want shit from nobody, and you didn't turn around and expect something from me because you're not getting it.
You ganged up.
I didn't even think it real deep.
I think it's even more than ganged up. I think she's standing on business.
Some motherfucking facts.
I think everything she's saying, because I ain't gonna lie, I'm sitting here waiting on you to kind of crack and say, like, you know, what the typical thing most women would, I ain't gonna say most women, most females who are trying to get into the entertainment space would say,
yeah,
to gain something. I've been kind of waiting on that answer from you, and you haven't said that one time.
Yeah.
So I respect what you're saying, because overall what you're saying is like I'm standing on the business of what I'm doing and what I'm selling.
Facts.
I just think being a female in general, and I just explained it's a male dominated industry, you all have the camaraderie and the ability to be in the boys' kind of vicinity and do y'all thing and thrive. But we have to think about how we are received at every fucking point. I don't get to let my hair down. You know what I'm saying? If I want the respect that I know I'm gonna motherfucking get, I have to hold myself to a high esteem. Yeah, like, what? You're not gonna play with me? Play with her.
I like that. I like that. Okay, you ain't cracking. Goes back to we was talking about the conversation, because we was trying to get it out of her. She not giving us that, fellas. So go back to the conversation earlier before we start filming. We was talking about getting on a jet or going on somewhere with a public figure. I think that's what everybody trying to do. Not even public figure, a drug dealer, whatever. Everybody trying to go on these vacations with a baller. That's what a vacation is right now in the internet world, right?
And I don't think it's nothing wrong with that for women who are single and they are in that space in their lives. I don't think that any woman who makes a decision to be in her independent space and live free and fly around here like a gypsy, like, baby, if that's how you feeling and that's the energy you in, cool. Facts. I don't judge anybody for living that particular life.
Yeah. But what about if you're in a relationship, right? Because it'd be confusing. Like, you know, what about if you're in a relationship and your girl get invited somewhere and the guy, or not even the guy, your girl's going somewhere and this guy's paying for wherever y'all going to. Say it's an island, Bali, wherever the fuck everybody be going, right? would you go and or you'd be like, no, I can't do it. I'm in a relationship. So I think that's like.
I particularly wouldn't go because it's not worth it for me. But a woman who does decide to go, it's probably worth it for her.
Why isn't it worth it for you?
Because look at the end of that experience. I mean, what did I get? A free trip, drunk. I gained some weight. Like, I'm off my schedule. Like, there's literally not much of a benefit there.
Do you do that in general? Bro, I mean, do you ever drink? Do you ever, you know?
If I'm thinking about having a good time, it's literally going to be with people who I absolutely love and know that I'm going to create memories with. Strangers, it's toss up. I don't know you. You could be whack as hell. Don't matter how much money you got.
Like, did you carry yourself like this before you got a relationship?
I had to be like this because I have to protect myself in this space. I live in L.A. by my motherfucking self. Mm-hmm. I know how to shoot guns. I don't fuck around.
Facts.
You from Chicago?
You from Chicago.
Southside.
Yeah, because that's another thing. A female guest I had come on here, and she was basically telling the ladies, you know, you got to carry yourself like a wife to be wife.
That's a fact. Habits are created through your daily practices and rituals. I get up every day, 7 a.m. I'm either praying, listening to the word, in the gym, while I'm, like, you know what I mean? Like, the Bible, having moral standing. All of that shit is, like, in me. Yeah. So it's not like for no play. Like, oh, I just want to say I'm cute in front of y'all. Like, I don't give a fuck about that. Yeah. It's about when I go home and I look in the mirror, do I fuck with me?
Yeah, because I notice I see like a lot of people, I'm not going to say all women, but I see some women, you know, they say like they'll settle down or they're going to stop doing certain things when they get in relationship. Right. Like, you know what I'm saying? But it's kind of like I feel like women want to, sometimes some women want to have some self-respect for the guy they're dating, but I think it's wise for a woman to respect herself and then men respect you for respecting yourself. Mm-hmm. And that's what you're giving me, you know, mm-hmm. so far, that you saying this ain't even about no guy and if I'm in a relationship or not, I'm gonna respect myself and everybody gonna respect
me. That's a fact. If you don't stand for nothing, you'll fall for anything.
You tough. I ain't gonna lie. I was expecting some hoe. I thought you was gonna be easier. I seen Instagram and everything.
So you
Instagram gets 10% of my personality. It's not me, 100%.
Really?
There's only so much of yourself that you can really put on any app for real.
I see but you're an entertainer though, so it's different. Like, you're an artist, but I see like you got certain pictures that's very I would say sexual.
Provocative.
Because that's a part of my personality as well.
Mm-hmm. So well, if you got your ass we'll out on see. Instagram, that don't mean nothing.
Let
really.
Let me see. What's your IG? Yeah, put it in there.
It ain't bad. It ain't bad at all.
Of course not. I mean, it's social media.
Number one, my ass is not out on any of those posts. So you can show me where you see an ass out see. Picture. But regardless.
This ain't your ass?
Is it out?
Low-key.
That motherfucker out. Like, under his arch. It look great, but I'm just saying. I have no problem with it. I love it, but I'm just saying. Y'all let me know. Am I tripping or not, y'all?
And what else do you see on my page?
It ain't nothing wrong with it. Trust me.
But what else do you see on my page, though? That's one post.
That's what I'm just saying.
And it was for Valentine's Day. What else do you see on my page?
Okay, so.
Some reels.
Okay.
Exactly.
So let's get this. What do you overall? So you're an actress?
Yes. Singer, okay. Dancer, performer, all of the above.
So what's the main thing? Like, what's your main thing you do?
I just told you.
Yeah, she's an actor.
I perform. I'm an artist. So whatever way I wake up that day and I decide I'm going to be creative, that's what I'm doing.
Okay, so I'm an artist, right? But right. I'm a rapper. So
and that's
I make my money off rap, right? As an artist, what do you do to like...
Whatever I want to do in that creative space. I am not limited to any box. And I'm also a Gemini, so I'm very good at a lot of different things.
I'm not saying being limited to a box, right? Like, we all got different things we do.
Right.
I guess I'm asking, like, coming from Chicago, like, what was, like, the thing that, like, put you in a path of being successful to be able to sustain yourself out here in Los Angeles?
Well, once I got introduced to acting, I feel like I was purposed in that. I'll be real with you. Like, music is still my love. That's what I want to be doing. That's what I prefer to have an output of. But music is very difficult to pioneer without a machine behind you. And so I feel like my purpose is taking me through all the blessings that I'm about to receive in this industry. So I'm focused on acting mainly, but there are so many different things that I do to make money on a daily basis. Like, tomorrow I'm going to go to the studio. The day after that, I'm going to be working on my pilot.
How do you make money going to the studio?
Once I put the content out, I make money off my content.
What you mean? What?
Why are you smirking like you don't understand?
No, because I'm trying to understand. Like,
if I go to the studio and I record a song, I'm going to make content off the song, and then I'm going to make money off the content.
So I think what Simba is saying, right, and then this is kind of what I was saying earlier, right?
What she's saying.
As an actor, it's like one plus one. Okay.
We say this because as actors and as, you know, musicians, I did, you know, music too, and I found myself never making money. Right, as much as I made the music, you know, you put it out there, the content, right, and so forth, you know, and you sit and you wait and hope for all these streams to come through, you know, and so forth, to make the money off of it, right? And even within acting, right, you can get this role and, you know, in this role and that role, and that's well, and that might, you know, pay you nice within those days, right? And then that's done, and now you're hoping and waiting for some type of royalty check, you know what I mean, that does not pay the bills. So even with music does not pay the bills. If anything, you're putting the money.
You can't say that for
all
artists.
No, listen, hold on. I'm not saying it for all people. I'm not saying it for all people.
You shouldn't be saying it for all artists. There's so many licensing websites.
I'm not saying it for all people.
Why y'all saying that?
But you can put your music on licensing sites, and there are sites who are looking for stuff to be pulled into films or televisions. Yes.
Nice. Send me the sites. I want to get money too.
I got you.
Yeah.
I feel like if you're going to ask me a question, you're going to ask it in a way to learn the information. That's cool. But don't be smug and make it seem like nobody can do.
I'm not being smug. I'm just saying I'm somebody that's heavily into music.
For sure.
So when you're saying certain things, you're saying things that really don't produce a lot of money in music. So to the person that's watching this episode, the questions they may have of how to make that money in music is the answer that I'm trying to get from you.
Okay.
And I know for a fact in music, and like, unless you, like, you know, got a crazy record or a crazy fan base or something where you selling a bunch of tickets or making a bunch of money off streams, it ain't really too much money there.
That's not true. He just explained to me before this podcast, there are so many independent filmmakers he met at Sundance Film Festival. Do you know how many of them are dying to have music in their stuff? If you have something that's in alignment, you can spend your time, listen to me, spend your time on IMDb Pro, and you go and you find these people who are directors, who are film, whatever they're doing, and you ask them, hey, I see you have a product that's in post-production right now. I'm going to send you my music, whatever. I would love, you know, to be a part of this, and that's negotiable. Then you need to hit up all the rest of them other directors. There are also licensing sites. YouTube has music that they, all these motherfucking sites is copywriting, putting copyright strikes on people's stuff because you have to pay the artist. So there's ways out here to hustle it. If you really, really trying to hustle it. If you sitting on your ass waiting on somebody to just come click on your video, then now you're not finna get no money, and that's on you.
Oh, mamas.
I agree with that.
Talk your shit.
So with that said,
let up on these niggas.
With that said, obviously, though, like, it's something that you have to be dedicated to when it comes down to it. Most people aren't dedicated, right? Even like the viewers watching, right?
So but she not talking about them. I know, so we can't even have that conversation about them. What she talking about is the motherfuckers that's really willing to get up and go get to it.
Exactly. Right.
And that's what
so
I'm saying.
So we talking about the people that's willing to really get up and that's go get fact. To it, right?
Everybody in this room is getting up and getting it.
Nah, for sure. But I know people that's like independent. Me personally, I'm a fan of the major system. Right, I fuck with the major system. I know a lot of people that's a part of the independent system, but I know a lot of work that they put in where they don't properly feel like they receive the capital based off what they're putting into it.
Yep.
Right? So what I'm asking you is, as somebody that's like an artist, right, and like, are you independent?
Yeah, I don't have any company that I'm working with.
Okay,
Ayona,
so
artist,
as somebody
LLC,
that
company.
Like gets up and go get to it,
right.
As you just explained, that's all I was asking. What's some of the things you do to be able to create revenue for yourself so somebody else can know that? So yeah. Like you said, emailing different producers and different directors, you know what I mean? Certain things like that. Most people don't have that information.
When you independent, you don't have a system working for you. You got to be the system.
Yeah.
So, you know, she explained, and that was a good question, because it's like, oh, that shit sound good. All you got to do is do that. Sounds
yeah.
simple.
Yeah.
Everybody
yeah.
say that.
That's all.
So let's get in deep in detail how people really doing this.
Right.
Because there's a lot of people that's mislead people
right.
and misguiding. You know, if you're not an entrepreneur, it kind of come off like, bro, I'm finna quit my job and I'm finna just do music because I could just upload
right.
it on. Bro,
right.
don't go broke trying
yeah.
to look cool.
And
exactly.
I never believed in that.
Exactly.
I never believed in that. I worked at a hotel when I first moved
mm-hmm.
to L.A. I didn't just start off. I told you I was doing background when
mm-hmm.
I first started. So as I'm doing background, I worked at a hotel. I worked at the Sofitel right on
mm-hmm.
La Cienega in Beverly.
Mm-hmm.
And I was there for 1 year. That was my first job here. And as soon as I quit, I never went back. Like,
so let me ask you this.
Respect.
We had a conversation with a young lady earlier.
We can't see you on the camera. If you want to talk,
hold on.
Because they can't see you.
They don't need to see me.
They need. Can I just say what she was saying? Has your song been picked up by several indie movies?
We need a mic. Get
yes.
Hand it.
Several, so
yes.
Not hand it, but you can spin it like
so
this.
You don't even have to do that. I just wanted to know because you're.
They can't hear you.
Okay. Well, I just wanted to know while she was. So what was your question?
My song is on The Man in 3B. It's also on another Tri-Destin film. I also have some.
Like more than 20 song times your song has been.
No, played? I only have 10 or so songs
right.
on
no,
Apple Music.
20 films.
No, it's been picked up by 5.
Okay.
Spin her the mic.
So it, no, I get what she's saying. Like,
saying
but people at home.
It's not a reliable source of income. I've had indie movies.
Talk
pick
shit
up
going.
My music, and I'm also an artist. And Simba's a huge artist, so I'm an independent artist. I work with some dope people,
yeah.
but I'm still independent. And I've had my music picked up by indie, and I didn't get paid shit, honestly.
Yeah.
And I've pitched to mega, and I've had and they're cool movies like Tubi and all that shit. But it's like. They're not really
you
paying.
Said
they're
Tubi.
Already. They're.
That's cool
they're
too.
Already.
That's
they're,
cool.
It's all bullshit.
I
no,
love
all
everybody.
Of it, I mean, no disrespect to any artist, and I don't want to proceed with this too far, but I'm just saying like, they're not really paying shit. So it's like that's not a sustainable source of income as an artist. And this man is doing
but if
billions.
You get, if you're getting a little,
streams.
If you're getting a little bit of everything.
A little bit of everything is great because it'll pay your bills.
Because
sure.
most
that's
people
what I'm promoting.
Yeah, that's
that
what she
I
own.
Do
yeah.
That's why I'm Ayona the artist. I'm not telling you that music is my bread and butter.
Mm-hmm.
If that's your bread and butter, I understand your struggle.
Right.
But that's not mine. I have the acting stuff. I'm
yeah.
also producing my own content. Mm-hmm. Like,
I just say that because he was saying like it's really no money in this shit.
Yeah,
I'm,
I understand.
Big artists,
I'm
because I paid from big artists. You like, for example, like a Big Sean or somebody. Not to say I know his polygamy, but somebody like Big Sean isn't really getting. It's not the money isn't in the music. The money is in the shows and the merch and the.
You know that as well, and I'm not telling you that you shouldn't be worried about. Just the like you should be an entrepreneur or business. You've seen
yeah.
these business models happen. When you go to a Kanye show, he's selling a hoodie for however many hundreds of dollars.
Mm-hmm.
If motherfuckers like you,
mm-hmm.
if they like you, they gonna buy whatever
exactly.
the fuck you selling. You could be selling panties, baby girl. So it's just about, I feel like, putting yourself in a position to not accept a no from
mm-hmm.
anybody
mm-hmm.
and to constantly put your, like, the machine needs to be going. Why the fuck is you out eating hot Cheetos? Bitch, you need to be figuring out how to make $5,000 tomorrow.
Let me tell you why.
Facts.
I love what she's saying, though, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you right with what you're saying, but I love what she's saying because
mm-hmm.
in so many words, what she's saying is what you were saying earlier,
mm-hmm.
right? What she's saying is, so earlier we was having this conversation about if somebody worked at a Subway.
Right.
Right? And they was like, the person that work at the Subway, they got a Subway mentality.
Right.
And he was like, you can't really say that because they could be there just kind of doing something to be kind of growing, kind of what you said with the hotel shit.
Exactly.
Right? So what you saying, and what she was saying was like, I can't be with somebody who's meant, I could be with somebody that work at a Subway if their mentality is just not to be comfortable at the Subway.
No.
That's overall what she was saying.
No, that's what overall what she was saying, but that's after 30 minutes of the conversation. So what?
But overall she said of I the was conversation right. is what she was
I
saying,
I understand,
though.
But we got to, for the people that wasn't, we understand because we was there in
but
real
I'm
life.
Trying, I was trying to shorten the convo okay. up, all right, you know what right. I'm saying, rather than like go into detail.
You don't want
to
get, that's whole, a good, that was good-ass conversation.
No, we could go into it. I was just trying to get her perspective.
But all in all, you looking for a limitless mindset, a mindset of abundance.
Yeah.
Like you, I'm not. There is no cap on whatever the fuck I'ma do in this world. That's why if you ask me, are you a singer? Well, is that what? No, I'm not no main nothing. I do a whole lot of shit. I used to play the saxophone. I used to play the piano. I did ballet, tap, jazz, hip hop, African dance. Like I did a lot of fucking shit growing up.
See, for me personally, I respect that because I'm somebody, I struggle with that.
Mm-hmm.
Like I can't do hella shit.
Got it.
I gotta focus on one thing and then grow into my other spaces based off that. Now I can attempt to do other things, but it's hard for me to like manage business and like focus on hella other shit rather than the main thing that's paying me.
True.
So that's why I was asking you that question, because it's a tough thing to like be an actor and register yourself for SAG and be a singer and do all your splits and get yourself in these rooms and produce your own content and write your own scripts.
You telling me, nigga,
like,
I'm
that
doing
shit is
shit.
A lot. So for it you is. To,
it's a fucking lot.
You know,
I'm
so that's
stressed,
what I'm saying.
I'm
like,
stressed if, all the time.
That's
so
what
I
I'm
understand.
Saying. For you to be somebody that's out here doing that, I commend that. You know what I mean? Like,
and that's a lot of it's a lot of money. I mean, you know, credit to what Simba's saying. Like that's me. I spread myself. I do this,
right.
and this.
Right.
But what I find myself a lot of times is wanting to really just have to kind of follow what his model is, right? You know, let me do this, right? So I could be successful in this, because what I find myself doing all these things and they're all growing, right? But all of it costs a little bit of money. All of it costs your time as well.
Okay.
And when it's not paying back.
I'm following y'all. Y'all basically saying, you know, being a jack of all, they say it's a saying, you know, you're a jack
exactly.
of all trades, you
and
master
none.
None.
Right.
So that's why y'all, everybody in this room, question was like, all right,
exactly.
so what the fuck?
What's
do
the
you
main
really
thing.
What's the main okay
exactly.
That's actually not the quote. The quote is a jack of all trades is a master of none, but still better than a master of one. They shortened the quote because they didn't want you to do more than one thing.
That's a
so
thing.
A jack of all trades is a master of none,
right.
but still better than a master of one.
Right.
So you're doing what you're supposed to be doing.
That's
you're collecting all back.
Facts.
Fact.
Oh, mamas, beat the system.
And you know what? With that, right? And I'm gonna tell you. So for me, as much as I did listen to my brother Simba, right, and take some of his traits, right, for me, I look at it like, okay, if I'm doing all of these things, once one go, the other ones are going to go as well, because it's going to give me enough time to be able to focus on the next thing, because I made some real money on this, or I read, like, this was successful, and you were able to, like, prove why you've been ripping and running, doing all of these, you know.
Yeah, but
she things.
Giving me more of the, she's an entrepreneur more than an artist.
Yeah,
absolutely. You know, and
me
I think
too.
And I think that was why it's good that y'all asking these questions, because go back to the fans that's watching, you know, a lot of people just be quick to be like, oh, I'm just quick to be an artist, and don't know the money that artists really make. You know what I'm saying? Everybody
that's
just wanted
the only reason I was asking.
You see what I'm saying?
That's the only
right?
reason.
Right. But her point is that she's not an artist. She's an entrepreneur. Of course you're an artist cuz you're a public figure, but you're an entrepreneur first. And that's, I'm speaking on your behalf, but that's
yeah,
what I'm getting out of you.
Yeah, I mean, I just feel like, first and foremost, like, in order for me to show up, the bag is has to be there. You know what I mean? And I feel like that's for all of us in this room. Like, we're not pulling up if the money don't make sense.
Facts.
Sure.
Because being artists and sitting in a studio and recording music all day, high as fuck, that shit sounds lovely. You know what I mean? Like, you just out here creating and making amazing music. And maybe somebody gonna hear it, maybe they fucking won't. But if you don't know where the debt or the bottom line of this shit is, then it's like, it's fucking pointless.
For sure.
Would you do a movie for free?
I have done, in the beginning of my career, I did, because the credit made sense. I'll be honest and say, I've actually done works on accredited shows even recently where it was like, okay, you have to be a local hire to do this. Bought my own hotel, bought my own flight. And so the money that they paid me for the project, I just was like, well, this credit is more important than me making profit in this situation because I'll make money through other people who see that I was a part of this project.
Do you feel like most female artists go that route, or they look for a man that's financially stable and want them to fund their dreams?
Okay. I have daddy issues. Mm-hmm. So first and foremost, I don't look for a man to do anything for me. Mm-hmm. Second of all, I just believe that any human being, no matter what gender, should always have their own shit going on. If you're not dreaming for yourself, thinking for yourself, living for yourself, somebody else is navigating you like a little puppet. And that's fine if that's what you're into, but that's not what I'm into.
So you don't consider, like, so what do you consider, because we talk about being entrepreneurs, we talking about, you know, being bosses, right, in our own way.
Right.
What do you consider a boss? Like, as a female, what's a, because everybody, I talk to a lot of females, everybody, so I'm a boss bitch, I'm a bad bitch, I'm independent. But what do you consider a boss female or independent woman?
I really believe a boss is an example of a leader. You know what I mean? If I can look at another woman and go, okay, she clearly has these things figured out. She also is making strides in those areas. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Looking at a woman like Beyonce, who has as many Grammys as she has, definitely feel like that's a blueprint. That's a staple. That's a model for other women to be like, okay, well, if she did that, I could fucking do that.
Mm-hmm.
Looking at a Michelle Obama, looking at women of high status and high, like, value, mm-hmm, and being like, hey, I can do something like that. You know what I mean? That's a leader. That's, yeah, somebody to model after. That's, yeah, what a boss is to me.
And even being a woman that's very independent, that's strong-minded, that respect themselves.
Absolutely.
When you decide to partner up and do business or just be in a relationship with a man, do you feel like you still have to have that same energy, or you choose to deal with men that, okay, I'm a boss and I'm, you know, I'm in control of a lot of stuff, but when you deal with a man, do you feel comfortable with taking the back seat, or you rather deal with a man that you can lead? I deal with men
on both sides. Like, someone who maybe I'm in a higher tax bracket than they are, but they're still building and still figuring it out. And I've dealt with a man who has more and has been able to teach me things. So I've dated.
What do you like the most?
I think that there are benefits to both sides.
What's the benefit of having a guy that you have to take the lead in being in a relationship?
I actually really enjoy the journey and the process of seeing somebody build. Like him saying that he just went to college at 30, I respect the fuck out of that. Mm-hmm. Like, the fact that you got out and said, I'm not wasting this opportunity, I'm actually gonna take this second chance and run with my life in the biggest direction I possibly can. Mm-hmm. And I also don't mind being a student of life. Anybody who is teachable is gonna fucking win. And that's just a fact. Like, you have to be teachable, you have to be able to learn, and that's in any space. Like, mm-hmm, so if I'm in a relationship with somebody who can teach me something, like, fuck yes. Like, I already thought I was killing shit, I'm about to win, like, more, because I got somebody that's gonna pour into me.
Yeah.
I just liked that whole little segment right there.
She go crazy. Real quick. You like the last of the dying breed.
I'm fucking doing.
Yeah.
So you were just telling me a minute ago that you went to Sundance this year. How was it?
It was my first experience being so green. I'm be honest, like, I wish I had built some relationships before going. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, I didn't have the access as much as other people had. But for the access I did have, I made sure to build relationships, especially with the strong women in that space, because they were the execs, the VPs, the, mm-hmm, you know, people who were writing, and a lot of black leads are needed in films this year or projects this year. So I just made sure to put my best foot forward. I stepped in that room with my good motherfucking shoes on.
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh, my mama. And, you got Simba over here quiet.
She ain't even got me quiet. I was letting her talk, because it's like, women like her should be highlighted.
Exactly.
You know, like, it's real rare to where we have conversations, like, even with you, like, today we was talking to her.
Mm-hmm.
It's rare where we have conversations with women in the industry to where they actually, like, taking the time to, like, plan their business out and, like, go to auditions and go to Sundance festivals and put their best foot forward to actually, like, win in the shit.
And not just receive money from randoms.
Yeah.
Or trips.
Not even that, but just, like, earlier we was talking about cheating. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, the overall definition of cheating is just to, you know, lie or misinform somebody to achieve some a goal. You know what I mean? So people skip steps all the time and could do things based off what they around and what they got access to. So to hear somebody,
I feel like that, like, it's such a waste of time. Like, if you can navigate sneaking and doing all that, like, nigga, go and do something with yourself. Like, you smart as fuck.
Yeah, right. How to work?
You can
internet.
Finesse like that. Like, go build some shit. Go create some shit with that. You're wasting time.
Exactly.
A lot of women come on here, you know, say a lot of things, but then you getting details. You know, they can't add to the details. It just sounds good. And I got my hyenas with me tonight. Yeah. So
for the future ladies that come on, you ain't gotta switch nothing. You ain't gotta come on and try to model behind her. Still come on and be yourself. You know what I mean? Cause this shit get ratchet too. You know, this was just more of a you know what I mean?
Nah, this just was somebody about their business.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like most people doing business in other areas. Like it's ain't too many women in the entertainment space, especially up and coming women. You know what I mean? Handling business.
Facts.
They don't even know the steps to handle business or who to talk to or, what that look like.
Men as well.
Yeah.
Same thing. It go both ways.
Yeah. Yep.
It go both ways. People in general.
That's let me go to the next question, because you running through these bitches. I'm very impressed. I'm so proud of you. Because I've been seeing you around for a minute. And I don't know, I couldn't read you, but do you think birds of a feather flock together when it comes to just men and women? Like, if a female got a lot of friends that's like hoes, it's, you know, do you think it's a high chance of her?
Well, you're speaking on alignment of mindset, so I mean, I kind of believe that whatever you enjoy or the person that you're spending your time with enjoys, like, you know, whether it's good, bad, or indifferent. I think there's definitely some similarities in those people. Now, are they exact same? Nah, but you enjoy that shit. They enjoy it too. You know what I mean? So.
Yeah. Why do women be lying, like, in relationships? I'm asking because I feel like a lot of people, we always talk about, you know, men cheating, and we know niggas ain't shit. That's very clear. But I think a lot of people don't hear from women why women do certain dirt. Because, you know, men
like
would be
that,
like,
you bypass that statement so quickly.
Yeah,
talking about them men be cheating and they ain't shit.
Like that,
that's really whack.
Why?
Like, why does that have to be the case? Why can't you be a stand up human being? Why do it have to be gender involved?
Yeah.
Because I'm just trying to be specific. How the fuck I say
it? I feel like there should be high expectations on both parties.
That's a tough one.
The same way y'all have high expectations for a lady to be a lady, I think that it should be high expectations for a gentleman to be a gentleman, and that's just what it is.
So, real quick. So, you see how my boy Simba is dressed, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
If you see him, right, dressed like that, do you ever think instantly, like, look at that gentleman?
I definitely thought that he was specifically choosing to be mysterious and that it was intentional. You know what I mean? Like, you want to exist in your space where you feel comfortable, and that's cool.
Can somebody with an image like that be looked at as a gentleman?
I don't know if you're a gentleman or not. I have to understand what you're about.
Now I'm a flip.
She called. She answered the questions.
Now I'm a flip it. But now
and for the people that can't see, he got a ski mask on right now, wearing
now
all
I'm
black.
I'm a flip it, but he could come and it'd be, you know, he got his 3-piece suit on, you know what I mean? And you can see his face and stuff like that. One will assume that he's a gentleman.
Right, but I'm not going based off of appearances. Like I said, I think I have to know what you're about.
Yeah, so that's
a person in a suit could be a sleazebag too.
But that's what that's what I was trying to get to. Right? Do your appearance, you know, of how you look, right, can often categorize who you are as a person without nothing actually being said. And I say that because in our industry, right, you know, like in film, right, they see me and I'm a rapper, or like, you know, I'm some type of, typically they look at me like that. And then, like, even with women and like black women, right, you know, instantly, oh, she's a dancer, or she's a stripper, or she does nails, or she does hair, you know, stuff like that, right? We have to conform to like what their stat quo is. And this goes back to, you know, earlier why I asked that question. a lot of times, you know, I walk in these rooms and I see it happen all the time, right? Even in filmmaking where, you know, for instance, if this black film is shown at a Sundance or whatever, you'll have all these critics who are supposed to watch the film, but then they don't sit through the whole movie and watch the film. They walk out after 15 minutes and then they'll write a bad review because they're automatically judging what this film is about because it doesn't fall into what their category of filmmaking actually is. And same with, you know, people like ourselves who dress the way that we dress and look the way that we look. We're not considered, you know, actors, or we're not considered, you know, directors or writers, you know, and producers and stuff like that. We're instantly put inside of this box. And that's why I was kind of, you know, asking you, do you ever feel like you're put in that box when you step inside of these rooms?
I mean, I definitely feel like, you know, you guys just heard Lewis explain that based off of what he perceived from my page, you know, you were trying to just kind of gauge like what I am about. And I think a person will look at my appearance and be like, okay, well, she dresses sexy and she's very confident, but this is how I feel like I look good. I don't really give a fuck what nobody think about that shit. And I'm still gonna get a bag. I'm still gonna be smart. And I'm still gonna hold it down when it comes to my job. So I just really feel like I don't particularly choose to judge a person. Mm-hmm. I feel like an amazing man could exist even in a homeless guy on the street. Like, oh my God, like that's an incredible, very well spoken, very wise, and in the know man. I don't think it has to be determined based on the hoopla. I mean, we should have learned that in COVID. Like, when we didn't, none of us could go no fucking where. Mm-hmm. You can't step out in your Rolls Royce. You can't go prove nothing and go shit on nobody. Mm-hmm. Like, you have to be a human being.
Yeah, a lot of people got in bad relationships during the pandemic.
And some got in good.
And some got in good.
You know?
On my mama.
This one.
This one. On my mama, when you ain't at the club, you like, we've been chilling in the house for like 3 months. They you got some game.
They got used to each other.
Yeah.
I definitely feel like I grew spiritually. We don't live together yet. We both have our own places.
That's healthy.
I want to move in. I want to move in and be married. I don't want to shack up. That's not my thing.
I've done it before.
I have shacked up once before, and I wasn't a fan of the outcome.
I think that's a good idea.
You wasn't a fan of the outcome because y'all didn't get married?
I just don't think that the foundation was based on God. I think God needs to be at the forefront of the space that I choose to be in. So. God, huh?
Well, you got to get more in detail. That sounds great. No, that's some real shit. But God.
No, I'm serious.
No, I feel you. No, I see where you're going, but we got to get more in detail.
I don't give a fuck. Listen, I don't give a fuck with nobody's opinion is about what I said. I said what the fuck I said. Ain't no relationship that's not based and rooted in the foundation with God being there. And I don't give a fuck what your religion is. If God is not in that space, that shit ain't going to fucking thrive.
No, God been in a lot of relationships. A lot of motherfuckers ain't work out.
I think God is in everybody's space, right? Unless you know, announce that, you know, you don't believe in God, you know what I mean, or whatever. But I think God is in every space, and I mean, shit. You know, but I love that that's what you know, you said.
But
that,
go
that's
back,
how
I
want
to go back to why you feel like it's, because I feel you on that. I think the, like, shacking up and living together, that's, like, it was a quote that said people ain't looking for love, they're looking for help. I think that's real. Like, a lot
that's
of people
true. That's
is
roommates
like,
because
I
financial
just feel
reasons.
Like, what is y'all playing for? You know what I mean? Like, if you finna be for play, and y'all not finna be serious about this partnership or in alignment about
do
this
you got
particular
any kids?
Space, no, I will not do that.
Would you rather be married first and then have a kid?
Absolutely. Why? Like, I want to have a good time with my husband before I decide to bring, like, the family into focus. I want to travel with my husband. I want to do fun shit. I mean, I do that in my relationship already, but especially when we're like an official union, like I think to me, marriage is just a fucking contract. You know what I mean? It's just like some shit on paper. You get to evade tax situations or whatever. Yeah. But I do honor the foundation and the acknowledgement from that man. Mm-hmm. I am honoring this woman before God. That's what I fuck with. You're making a decision. You're not playing with me. You're not wasting my fucking time. I'm not wasting your time. Like, we're doing this, my nigga. Stand on your shit. You said that shit, so, like, stand on it.
You think you could do that without a contract?
I can, but, you know, the nature of men, I don't know. Y'all be on some funny shit.
So if you have a, so you want, like, if you have a relationship with a man, it's like, hold on, this contract kind of like holds you to some shit. Not necessarily me, because I'm all the way in, right? But it's going to hold you to something, right? And is that the prenup?
What do you mean?
To hold you to something, you know, because you said that you can, right, without right. the paperwork, right. Right? Right? But with him, you know, like you said, y'all men, you know, y'all tend to whatever it may be. So it's like, if you could do it and you believe that this man can do it, it's the contract is kind of what binds him to doing it.
I just feel like nobody is typically, when you are deciding to get married, like, if you are disrespecting this person, that could be on the woman's side or the man's side, if you're disrespecting this person and there's a vow that you've made in front of God and a whole bunch of other fucking people, yeah. you're probably less likely to, I mean, men still slip, yeah, women still slip.
You can do that without a contract, though.
I feel her on that, though.
I think real niggas is just gonna be real niggas. Like, you really can't teach that.
What do you consider a real nigga? What's a real nigga?
If you stand on your word.
Yeah, okay. So
that night shit. Honor my sword. Like, that real nigga shit.
If your man wanted to marry, because you're in a relationship, if your man wanted to marry you tomorrow, if he proposed to you, and was like, fuck it, let's just get married this week. Like, let's not even wait. And you were super excited. But then before the wedding, he proposed a prenup. Would you sign it?
Sure. I'm the one that makes money. So I'm going to always make the money. So I don't give a fuck.
Okay. I like that.
Back to like what I was saying. So it doesn't matter. The contract actually doesn't matter, right? Now, yes, you can say, like, you know, evade taxes or whatever it may be. I don't know that part of, you know, tax law or whatnot, but I've always envisioned, like, I don't like the concept of contractual marriage, right? Because it is a spiritual thing, and that's how I feel, right? Yes. You know, but I do for me, it's a little different. My last name is True Love, and I feel like I have to give that last name away. And it's like, if I don't give that last name away, I'm like, I'm a sucker, you know what I mean? And my mama, like,
that's so cute. That's his real last name.
What you give me that last name for? And it's hard. It's tough trying to get this last name away, because I'm going to give it away, you know what I mean? But then when I give it away, I want it to be a union, you know, spiritually, before it goes to a point of being, because the only way you can change your name is X, Y, Z. You got to give all these reasons. So I have to do it that way. But, you know, I like to believe that my mom and dad been in a relationship for 37 years, and in a relationship for 37 years, they ain't never got married.
Oh shit!
They've been in a relationship for 37
Nigga,
years.
Nigga, on the last episode, you said your parents was married.
No, I didn't.
I can pull up the clip.
Pull it up.
All right, I'm gonna pull. Y'all pull up the clip.
Yeah, my parents been together for 37 years, bro.
I don't know. I might be wrong, because
is she satisfied with never having received a ring from him?
Yeah, I wasn't satisfied for a minute, but then I had to understand, you know, growing up in the projects in the hood, there's certain reasons why you don't do shit like that, right? Like, if they would have got married, then we would have to pay extra rent, you know what I mean? Like, in the Jets, he would have had to get put on a lease, you know what I mean? When he working a city job, it's like, hold on. So, you know, for a long time, and then my mama white.
Where is this episode going?
It could get real funny, you know what I mean? Because I'm a comedian sometimes too. But
you a jack all trades too, right?
At times. But anyway, yeah, that's how I feel. Like, I know I have to give my name away, but now at the same time, if it wasn't for that, I would just want something spiritual. I want the wedding, though. I want the whole wedding and all that shit, right? But I just don't want it to be
generation.
Like,
contractual. Fuck.
No disrespect, but do you feel like she not getting no ring was because it had anything to do with her being white?
No, not at all. It wasn't. She got a ring. She got a ring and everything.
So, yo, mom.
Contract. Just no contract. Just no contract.
I understand that.
Four kids.
I wouldn't do that, but.
Hell, fuck no.
Yeah.
I need you to make up your mind.
He's not even my biological dad, neither. That's what's really
who you great. Fucking playing with? Would you want somebody to play with you?
I don't believe in marriage.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah. So, okay, look at you.
You don't believe in marriage, but you want a guy to be committed to you? Just like.
I believe in commitment, but I don't believe that me signing a paper through the government makes it any more real than us, you know.
Agreeing.
But I do believe if we have rules and communication set.
If you got a boy, if you got a boyfriend, you don't want him to deal with other women.
That's not my preference. No, but I also know I feel like all men cheat. But you know,
you think all men cheat?
Yeah.
Do you think all men cheat?
I don't date white men.
Absolutely not. I have been with amazing, amazing, amazing. I'm not going to lie to you. I have been with amazing guys. Like a guy who I was like, damn, I still ain't found shit. Like, because I'm looking. Not often.
So because but you I'm ain't looking, found it, don't be
no,
cheated.
No. I'm just, I'm saying like there are some, some stand up.
There are some
in the world. Like
there
legit.
Are some.
No, actually, I should take that back just out of respect for other people's relationship. I should say like the type of men that are exciting to me, they cheat.
Then that's what your choice is.
I like how you use that.
That's yeah, you worth it,
you
right?
Can choose, you
right,
can choose. Right, yeah. You there, can choose.
There is. There it is.
Yeah.
What
yeah.
She said is very true.
The type of men I would want to like just have fun, like build a life with. I don't like bobs and bills. Like, I like a certain type of guy.
Can the people hear her? Can you turn your mic?
Come here. Come
turn,
to her
yeah,
here.
Yeah, turn the mic.
Come to her.
Nah, you saying some interesting
we'll
shit.
We'll get an episode. Yeah. We'll get an episode. All
right. Right.
I want right. to be on that episode.
I don't feel any type of way about how, she, like, that's yeah. her life. And she thriving.
Yeah.
Baby girl. Like, yeah. She happy as fuck over here. Y'all can't see her. She's smiling real big. So, you know what I mean? She happy with that.
Yeah.
And you got to be happy with what we're happy with.
I agree with her. Like, I don't believe in marriage.
I thought this
neither,
episode was
going to
be toxic.
To.
I thought she was toxic.
Oh, shit. Nah. That's fucked up.
That's yeah. me assuming.
Hell no. Nah.
And I'm glad it ain't toxic
film.
Because.
He said that you was in film and stuff like that. And then, you know.
But we was
like, going to
talk
you know,
about the personal shit. I knew she's phenomenal at her craft and her art. I respect her as an artist. I didn't know what type of woman she was. That's so separate.
I love this open dialogue.
Yeah, I love it.
Let's say that.
I love it.
I think we get a lot of little clips, you know, out of it.
That's all I'm doing. That's what I'm trying to ask her. I'm trying to get shit out. I'm like, we ain't going to have no clips. This is a great-ass episode. A woman with some fucking self-respect and some substance came on here and answered all the questions and shit. It's the Cali Kickback.
Well, you asked me about what my podcast is going to be about. I told you it's going to be some healthy shit. So
that's good.
I'm trying to heal the community. Yeah,
exactly.
Man.
We need it.
We need
but
it.
But we can't fake it. It got to be real. You got to live by it. Because there's a lot of people on these podcasts and all these shows saying all this great shit and then doing otherwise. So I'll be trying to get a little deeper.
I mean, the truth going to always come to light. And that's what I fuck with. Like, even if, you know what I'm saying? Like, you speaking your truth about your past and like your family and shit, like I really fucking respect that.
Oh, mamas.
There's nothing that nobody, like, you can't pull my card because, bitch, I'm an open book.
Yeah, exactly.
No, it's important for me to be like that, like, you know, come from where I come through, knowing my story and my history and shit like that, to hide from it, you know, is to not be able to, you know, be that light, you know, to, you know, the younger generation and other people who might be going through things as well.
Yes.
And identifying like, okay, I am this person.
Yep.
And, you know, and that's what I try to ultimately do. Like,
appreciate
I am this.
Shit.
Well, this is the Cali Kickback. I appreciate you coming through. One thing I want to tell you before you get up out of here.
What?
First of all, I'm glad you came. I've been trying to get you to come for
Thank
a minute.
For
We've both been busy.
Me.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I'm impressed with who you are as a person, as an individual. I didn't know all this about you.
I appreciate
so
that.
So I'm glad you came on here. And for the because it's important for the fans and people that not familiar with you to know what type of person you is. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot of artists. It's a lot of people. But it's not a lot of people that have some type of self-respect for themselves. And, you know, they can stand on what they can stand on. And I respect people that stand on shit. And I didn't know that about you. So
you know what? I do think that whatever intimate details that you or any of us have about ourselves, it's a very sacred space. And we are all blessed to share each other's energy in this moment and say some real shit.
Yeah, for real. Yeah. Nah, you got anything you want to promote before you get up out of here? You know what I'm saying? Tell the people where to find you or, you know, any updates before we wrap it up.
Well, if you would like to subscribe to any of my channels, it's Ayona the Artist, Ayona the Artist, on YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram. I will have some new projects coming out soon, and I'm working on a pilot for a TV show that's hopefully gonna come out.
Yeah, you know, make more moves than announcements. You understand me? You got your merch and everything, right? You got it online. I see now your bio and all that.
Yes, the artist collection. If y'all want to grab a couple of sweatsuits or some tees and caps, I got some stuff for y'all.
Yeah, and she independent. You understand me? So you know, if you support that, you supporting her. You understand me? So that's how we get down on Cali Kickback. You understand me? Millie, how you feeling? You want anything you want to say before we wrap it up?
How y'all doing, everybody? My name is Jamal True Love. These guys call me Millie, but you can find me on all platforms at Jamal True Love. JamalTrueLove, no E, because in the middle it'll be two words. So yeah. And I got some film shit coming up too, you know what I mean? So you know, just peep it.
Yeah. Love it's the Cali Kickback. It's your boy Lewis Belt, San Diego. I will be in your city on the 26th. Make sure y'all pull up, you understand me? And that's about it. Thank you. I love everybody. Make sure y'all subscribe.